the union of these 200 people. We are here to unite Jamie and Danielle in marriage and to celebrate this very special moment. Before you both are joined together in marriage, in my presence and in the presence of these, your family and friends, I am bound, as you know, to remind you publicly of the solemn, mysterious, and the binding nature of the relationship of which you are now about to enter. Marriage, as most of us understand it, is a voluntary and full commitment of a man to a woman and a woman to a man. It is made in the deepest sense to the exclusion of all others and is entered into with the desire, the hope, and the firm intention that it will last for life. Before we continue, a little more about love. Love is like magic, and it will always be. For love still remains life's sweet mystery. Love works in ways that are wondrous and strange, and there's nothing in life that love cannot change. Love can transform the most commonplace into beauty and splendor and sweetness and grace. Love is unselfish, understanding, and kind, for it sees with its heart and not with its mind. Love is the answer that everyone seeks. Love is the language that every heart speaks. Love cannot be bought. It is priceless and free. Love, like pure magic, is life's sweet mystery. Do you, Jamie, take Danielle to be your lawfully wedded wife, to love, respect, and honor her throughout your years together? Yes, that was period. And then, okay, so now Danielle knows the punchline. Do you, Danielle, take Jamie to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love, respect, and honor him throughout your years together? Okay, perfect. So now can we have the rings, please? Okay, so these are our official Greek wedding blessings, which I will then translate. Από τη στιγμή αυτή που ενωθήκατε με την ελεύθερη συνένεσή σας σε γάμο, οφείλετε αμοιβαία ο ένας στον άλλο αγάπη, πίστη και σεβασμό για όλη σας τη ζωή. Ο γάμος που σας ενώνει σας επιβάλλει την ταύτιση των τυχών σας και την κοινή αντιμετώπιση σε βάση ισότητας όλων των ζητημάτων που θα προκύπτουν από τη συμβίωσή σας σαν Salzi Sigon, in den Modena Ordo di Spagnol, Isolis.
Okay, what I meant is, from this moment on,
you are now united as husband and wife. It is your duty to love, honor, and be faithful to each other. As husband and wife, you now have a common destiny. Together as equal partners, you will face whatever life may bring your way. And from this moment on, you are joined together for as long as you both shall live. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jamie, you may now kiss your bride.
Ooh. It's
official. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time, I'd like to present Mr. and Mrs. McGrath.
Yeah.
We're just from a humble family. We don't do things like this. But what a stunning location this is.
Yes.
Absolutely stunning. I'd like to welcome all the guests to our darling daughter's wedding. To my son-in-law, my new son-in-law, Jamie. Welcome to our family. And just look at some of the dresses on the girls. Wow. Wow. To the flower girls. All the bridesmaids. You all look stunning. Even the little page boy, where is he?
Oh yeah, Jake.
Firstly, I'd like to offer my condolences to the Kreft family on the sudden passing. And I'd like to wish all the people who's not here with us today to raise a toast to family and friends who are not with us. To Grandma and Granddad Angela and Vince, Grandma Pauline, Granddad Ken, Auntie Lisa, Uncle Brian, and Auntie Julie. And we all raise a toast to people who are not with us today to celebrate this lovely occasion.
To Barbara.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'd like to thank Mum for bringing our darling daughter up through all these years, through all the tantrums, through all the spells of all that teenage years. You did an amazing job. I'd like to thank Carmen, step-mum, for all the advice you give, the calming influence on the family. I'd like to thank Sister Georgia for a lovely song today. I thought that was quite moving. Well, hello, Dan. Where is she? Hi, Dan.
Dad.
There you are.
We've
done lots together, haven't we? Me and you over the years. Oh wow, blimey. Remember that trampoline incident in the park? Used to love that little trampoline. Every day she'd go, every week. Bouncing. Enthusiastically. Till you went over the side. And a big golf ball in your head. We used to go to the football together. That was the main thing of me and you. Wigan and Liverpool. Are any Liverpool fans here? Have we any Wigan fans here? Have we any Everton fans here?
Yeah!
Commiserations.
We live in Bordeaux.
So we went to Portsmouth one weekend. Do you remember that, Dan? Dan's favourite player at the time. This is one for the lads. He was a right back from France called Pascal Chimbonda. He scored the winning goal against Fulham in the 90th minute. The week after, me and Danielle are going to Portsmouth. We get to a bar, we have a few drinks. I think you're only about 11 at the time. We goes into the bookies. Dad's putting a bet on because Dad knows how to bet. Danielle says, "Where's Pascal Chimbonda on this list, Dad?" I said, "Well, let me educate you here. He's a right back. He doesn't score goals. I know he scored last week, He's not going to score again this week. So the game was on. It's 5:30 kickoff in Portsmouth. It's bonfire night. We can get a corner. Up pops Chimbonga. And puts it in the back of the net. 50-1. And Dad didn't back it.
Sack it, Dad.
Well, we had your teenage years then, didn't we, Don? All your teenage years thinking you could drink, ringing people up at various times of the night, not in a good state. And then we had your boyfriends.
Look at Jeremy's face.
And one thing I'd always said to the boyfriends was, you look after my girl, and me and you will be friends. Because this is where I come on to Jamie. So I think she meets Jamie on a holiday, was it, in Turkey?
Cyprus.
Not far away. I think on the second holiday they went out together, Danielle rings me up in such a state. Dad, it's awful. I said, what's awful? There's sick everywhere. Sick what? All over the room. So where's Jamie? Oh, he's asleep on the bed naked. Not only that, she said, Dad, all the cleaners have got mops and buckets. They're mopping up round him and he's still asleep. Jamie. Look after my daughter, me and you'll be friends. That's the first rule. So that just leads me to just say how much I'm extremely proud of you both today. Have a fantastic life together.
Yes.
But mainly, look after each other.
Yes.
Here we are.
One last thing, Jamie. Danielle, thank you so much for bringing Scarlett and accepting Scarlett in our lives. She's such a lovely, humble joy.
Aww.
And you too, honestly, along with your sister Georgia. She's so proud of you all, and we love you for that. God bless you all.
Everyone looks amazing today, but I guess the most important person is Danielle, sure.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah, she was so special today. It's hard to imagine the first time we met that we get married. Oh.
Come on, Jamie.
Go on, Jamie. Come on, Jamie. Yeah, so hard to imagine the first time we got married, we get married, but the time you're on, and you want you to be a part of my life. It's, I'm so happy we're all here now. It's been a hard time. I just wish me and Danielle can have half the marriage, me and my nan did. My nan got lovely. So I just can we all raise a glass to them?
Yes.
I hope they'll be number 7 tonight, they won't. That's all I've got.
Barbara and Ginger!
Yeah!
Richard, are you ready? Come on, Richard.
It's great to see so many beautiful people here today to celebrate Jamie and Danielle. Today's definitely been a long time coming with COVID and all that's happened, but I'm so happy we're finally all here together. And they say the best things in life take time and patience, so I think this certainly fits the bill. I'd like to say a big thank you to the bride and groom for letting me say a few words here tonight. So I've known Jamie now for 15 years, and I think our friendship is one of the things I cherish most in my life. We grew up together, and even though we don't see each other nearly as much as we should do, every time we do, it's like nothing's changed.
Nice.
And I think to me, that's what true friendship should feel like. There's kind of that unspoken understanding there. You get to know someone pretty well over 15 years. I think if you asked old friends from school to describe Jamie, the first thing they would mention would be his sense of humour, you know, sarcastic banter, or just how easygoing he is. Honestly, everyone loved Jamie, and I think he hasn't lost any of that charm today. But I think all of those things mentioned just now are true, but when I really think about it, what stands out most for me is Jamie's own self-belief, his humility, how hard he works. He's never been afraid to make his own decisions and do things his own way in life. And just on that point of doing things his own way, this is the man that once packed what was basically an Indian buffet to Duke of Edinburgh camping expedition. So imagine the two of us, 1 a.m. in the morning, freezing cold in a pitch black field in the middle of Isle of Man, desperately trying to cook his tin of M&S Bombay potatoes on a broken gas camping stove. No, but in all seriousness, look, doing things your own way in life requires great courage. I don't say enough to him, but I'm so proud of all of his success and everything he's achieved so far. I'm also so happy that he's found such a wonderful partner in Danielle. You're one of the kindest people I've ever met, and seeing how quickly you've become part of the family is just amazing to see. Danielle. Danielle, you look incredible tonight. And the love and care you have for each other is so clear. You've already built so much together. Together, I have no doubt that you'll be the very best husband and wife and future parents. So I'd like to invite everyone to raise their glass in a toast to the newlyweds. Here's to wishing you both a lifetime of love and happiness. Yamas.
Yamas. Yamas.
Enjoy it. What's that?
Japan.
Japan.
You should have got one of those that clicked on your head like a cold wind flight.
Thank you.
Yeah.